Hey, I'm Coulter here with another episode of JAG TV. We have another special guest reporter from Pleasant Hill Elementary to share information on an influential African American who focused on African American issues for women, including unemployment, illiteracy, and voter awareness. Here's Emery Carter with more on this Dorothy Height.
Dorothy Irene Height was born in Richmond, Virginia on March 24th, 1912. At an early age, she moved with her family to Franklin, Pennsylvania to attend the New York University, where she graduated in 1933. Height began her efforts as a civil rights activist at the age of 25, when she joined the National Council of Negro Women. Throughout her life, she fought for equal rights for both African Americans and women. During her time as an activist, Dorothy Height even got to work with Martin Luther King Jr. In 1963, Height was one of the organizers of the famed March on Washington. She stood close to Martin Luther King Jr. when she delivered his I Have a Dream speech. Height was the first person to treat race inequality and gender inequality as one issue. Height received many honors for her efforts to society. In 1994, President Bill Clinton awarded her for the Presidential Medal of Freedom. She later became friends with Barack Obama, who called her the godmother of civil rights movement. Height received many honors for her efforts to society. In 1994, President Bill Clinton awarded her for the Presidential Medal of Freedom. She later became friends with Barack Obama, who called her the godmother of civil rights movement.
Height was credited as the first leader in the civil rights movement to recognize inequality for women and African Americans. Since it is Black History Month, theater is doing The Color Purple for their production. The show opens tonight. Jaden has more information on this event.
In lieu of Black History Month, the theater department has dedicated their February plays to famous African-American films with predominantly African-American cast. In the past, they performed A Raisin in the Sun, A Cabin in the Sky, but have chosen The Color Purple to be this year's play. The story follows Celie, an African-American teenager, as she narrates her life and trauma through letters to God in hopes of resisting the self-concept placed upon her by others. It depicts the injustice during that time period as well as the perseverance of the Black community, a perfect choice for dedication to Black History Month. The play will be directed by Drew and Jason and will star Harmony Crump as Shug, Ben Newman as the Sheriff, Matthew as Father, Kiana as Squeak, and John Albert as the Mayor. There will also be several new members performing, including Aislinn Jones as Celie, Kenzie Thomas as Nettie, Alexa Cooper as narrator, and Braylon Carter as Harpo. Finally, Sophia will be performed by Genesis Weeks, a freshman who stepped up to fill the empty role. The performance will be held on February 16th, 17th, and 18th at 7 p.m. in the PAC and will have a $5 entry fee. I'm Jaden with JAGTV.
Be sure to attend this production tonight, tomorrow, or Saturday night. Knowledge Bowl competed last weekend in the county championship and won for the first time.
Last Saturday, Knowledge Bowl competed in the annual DeSoto County High School Knowledge Bowl Tournament at Olive Branch High School. Each school had two teams, which were divided into two brackets. There were five rounds per bracket, and the top two teams from each bracket advanced to the semifinal rounds based on wins, then points. The winners then advanced to the final round. Each round consisted of 20 questions worth 10 points, ranging from calculus to current events. Both DeSoto Central teams advanced to the semifinal round. One team had no losses, and the other team had the most points. Lewisburg's teams also advanced in the same way. In the final round, DeSoto Central took the victory with a 100-35 win over Lewisburg to clinch the first place spot for the first time in tournament history. Knowledge Bowl will travel to Ole Miss for a competition in March and travel to Itawamba Community College for the state championship in April. I'm Bella with JAG TV.
Congratulations to Knowledge Bowl and good luck in your upcoming competitions. Mayan C has this week's football teacher of the week. Let's see who he chose and why.
All right, I'm Mayan. I chose Ms. Syntag for my teacher of the week. She's just one of the best teachers, good foreign language teacher. She makes teaching easy. easy to learn in her class. When it comes to like certain work, she helps you out, make sure you turn stuff in. Always forgiving, just a really nice teacher. Tries to make everything fun.
Congratulations to Ms. Syntak, and thanks for being an amazing teacher. Valentine's Day was on Tuesday, and we had some members of the International Club say I love you and happy Valentine's Day in another language. Let's watch.
Te amo.
Main aapko pyar karta hoon.
Eu te amo.
Mahal kita. Happy Valentine's Day.
Feliz dia dos namorados.
Valentine's Day mubarak.
Feliz Dia de San Valentín.
And a little bit about our International Club is that we express other people's ethnicities and cultures in our school, and we do daily, monthly activities with other cultures to celebrate different types of traditions and holidays.
International Club meets on the first Thursday of each month. See Ms. Fowler for more information on this club. We polled students to find out who their favorite teachers were. Let's see who they said.
My name is Carl Rainey, and my favorite teacher is Mr. Mayo because he's the most involved in the school, and he doesn't care what he says because he doesn't care.
My name is Isaiah Daniels, and my favorite teacher is Miss Caldwell because she's just the best, period, and everybody loves her.
My favorite teacher on this campus is Mrs. Fenema, for pretty obvious reasons.
So my favorite teacher is Miss Simmons because she actually like tries to teach and it's actually really fun. She plays games and she's nice. So my favorite teacher, Miss Simmons.
Hi, my name is Carmen and my favorite teacher is Coach Bryant. He's my favorite teacher because he's always there for people and like teaching wise, he's gonna make sure you know what you're supposed to be learning. And yeah.
All right, I'm Kaylee Fenema, and I know that I'm supposed to say that other Fenema is actually my favorite teacher here, and sometimes he is, but right now my favorite teacher is Miss Leninger because, I mean, she's the best. She's literally our teacher of the year, and she deserved every second of it, so I'm picking her, and he can get over it.
My name is Jordan, and my favorite teacher is Miss Kimbrough. Why? Because she's always nice to me, and she used to give me honey buns and stuff every day.
With such great teachers on campus, it's hard to choose a favorite, but mine is Miss Carter. This week's weather has been very warm, but tomorrow high will be 45. Bella and Sam will let us know if the cold weather is sticking around or if it will warm back up next week. Here they are with next week's weather.
Hi, I'm Sam.
And I'm Bella.
And we're here with next week's weather.
On Monday, it's going to be cloudy with a high of 64 and a low of 49.
On Tuesday, it's going to be cloudy with a high of 71 and a low of 56.
And on Wednesday, there's going to be 40% chance of rain with a high of 60 and a low of 43.
On Thursday, it's going to be sunny with a high of 66 and a low of 39.
And on Friday, it's going to be partly cloudy with a high of 66 and a low of 36.
And that's it for next week's weather.
Spring sports are in full swing. Archery and baseball open their seasons and softball starts tonight, while basketball heads to the second round of playoffs. Here are Jaden and Campbell with last week's sports recap and next week's upcoming events.
Hey, I'm Jaden.
And I'm Campbell, and we're here with this week's sports recap and upcoming events.
Brooklyn Gaines, Kayla Tillman, and Tristan Mins competed in the MS Association of Coaches All-Star Bowling Meet last week.
Anne-Marie Barton, Casey Canizaro, Caitlin Elbeck, Jacob Garcia, and JT Reeser were all chosen for the West team in the North Mississippi All-Star Game.
Archery finished second in their season opener last Thursday, defeating South Haven, but losing to Lewisburg by 1 point. Zoe Caldwell had the second highest score of the meet. They have a meet tonight at Lewisburg and will travel to Center Hill on Tuesday.
Girls basketball fell to Center Hill in a district championship, but beat Clinton 55-40 in the first round of playoffs Monday night. Taria Hoslett had 24 points and 3 steals. Tylen Payne had 10 points and 10 rebounds. They will travel to Horn Lake tomorrow for the second round of playoffs.
Boys basketball lost to Olive Branch in the district championship, but defeated Murray in overtime 58-56 in the first round of the playoffs on Tuesday night. KJ Patrick had 15 points and 3 assists. Bob Dixon had 13 points and 7 rebounds. Freddie Ards had 12 points and 1 steal. They will travel to Horn Lake tomorrow for the second round of playoffs.
Baseball fell to South Panola in their season opener 2-3. They play MRA this weekend. And next week, they play at South Haven on Monday. That game starts at 7.
Tennis won their season opener against Olive Branch. Ryan Crosby and Taylor Burks both won their individual events. Ethan Lennox and Alex Abadie won one of the boys' double matches. Lindsay Ruff, Abby Grace Dendy, and Mackenzie Burks, and Kaylin Elbick won the two girls' double matches. Kelly Lavoie and Lane Wolf won the mixed doubles match. Tennis plays tonight at Olive Branch and hosts Lake Cormorant on Tuesday.
Softball plays tonight against Strayhorn. Varsity starts at 5:30, and they travel to Oxford on Tuesday, and they host Lafayette on Thursday.
That's all for this week's sports.
Students who scored a 30 or higher on the ACT were recognized at the board meeting this week. These students were Callan Accord, Amy Baugh, Bethany Bennett, Adriana Cantrell, Ryan Crosby, Haley Farrell, Dorian Fly, Michaela Fulford, Carter Gross, Adrian Guerra, Presley Hickey, Sean Hildreth, Alana Jordan, Isabella Lozano, Chloe Perkrebeck, Danielle Robertson, Drew Sheehan, Emily Smith, Cole Stork, and Avery Stratton. If you are interested in being on the cheer team, there's an interest meeting February 21st at 6 p.m. in the cafeteria. Prom tickets are on sale this week and are $60 this week and will be $70 next week. Students can buy tickets on RevoPay or purchase during lunches. Students need to complete a form prior to purchasing tickets. Dues must be paid to attend prom. No one who has attended DCAC this school year can attend prom. Guests from a different school must be approved. Prom Queen and King forms are due March 21st. All prom forms are available outside the main office. Rho Kappa National Social Studies Honor Society applications are available outside B9 and G111. Juniors and seniors with a 3.0 GPA and two semesters of social studies can apply. These are due next Wednesday. Most beautiful applications are available in the main office, the 9th grade office, and outside B29 and B27. Choir is selling hot cocoa and donuts in the Commons on Monday and Wednesday mornings. Congratulations to Cheer for getting 5th place in game day at Nationals last weekend. Chess, National Art Honor Society, and Interact Club will meet on Tuesday morning. Dungeons and Dragons will meet Wednesday morning. Hands and Paws will meet Thursday morning. Student Council, FCA, and Anime Club will all meet next Friday morning. Don't forget tomorrow is a student holiday and Monday is President's Day, so we will see everyone next Tuesday. Enjoy your extra long weekend. Baseball opened up their season Tuesday. Here's a hype video created by senior volleyball player Madison Fairley. I'm Coulter with JAG TV.